Thank you. Thank you. and you can forget your IPT in the several cases. So we see that on the server and on the phone manifold part of the screen, these can be bigger than 4. True for every key rather than 4. However, on the hearing server, it's only 16 out of 3, and keep alert on Hexcode Dictionary, we only have the result that key is right out equal to 6. So just briefly mention this. At this point, in fact, there is an improvement here, so we'll get something more. But we will come to this later. I just wanted to say one time theory where we have the same expression in T many times in X, so if you wonder what condition is, we will make clear. Okay, now, why seven is to get this next year to not to find the proof of closeness in the critical space? If we want to argue by the contraction acting principle, then what we do is we have to have some critical dynamics get first by when it's here, to get another control with the experiment. And so what we are shooting for is an L6 technique. Right. And we have to bound the integral of the integral of the expression by a factor of frequency, but this bound should not depend on the high frequency with a positive power. And if we look back here, we see that we cannot avoid getting the high frequency into the game without just use the linear system. So we have to get a new idea what we can do. And one way out is, and I think this was used also the first time I think by Bushman and Trekov, and they are working with the we want to prove critical trilinearity. And the starting point is the problem. In all those four cases, we want to improve the null of 6 estimate, which looks like this, by using almost functionality in space and time. And then we can prove the following estimate in every of these four cases. And for example, the which case is what I have now in Trekov, on the duration of the myself, on the episode 2 by the half size, and on the four sides of this. So by the improvement, we have three functions over here, the product of three functions in L2. And so what we get is we get one of these factors. And what's very important here, we've only depended on the low frequency, on the second low frequency, and we do have depended on the high frequency, but we gain something low. So this is a negative power, and this is very crucial. So if you don't think about this, you just forget about this term, and we have gaining a million estimates. But this term over here, and this term that we get a little bigger, gain a little bigger than one. And this is the main advantage. And trying to estimate implies local wave functions and global wave functions for small initial data. And this is true for every three-dimensional smooth angle. And this was set out by the paper of the Hamilton, but I think it goes back to the iteration phase that was first introduced by Hamilton and Spectrum. So this is the main ingredient. This in the paper will just kind of remark how this exactly works by the angle of the sun. So this is a remarkable. Okay, and now I want to convince you that gaining this trying to estimate is not very complicated. The technique is very simple. And okay, so let's do this. Let's recall what the linear evolution looks like. And now, in our four cases, it looks typically like this. So, what we have in common here is, we have t times the modulus of n squared, something similar here, something similar here, something similar here. So, this has to all these estimates that are all these linear evolution tests in common. And then, on the truth, we have a factor here, which makes the function of the inverse Fourier transform. And of course, we have something similar on the equation as well, where x, so alpha n, is defined by this sum. And now, on the product of the case of n squared 2, we want to write x and theta to the sum of omega, where theta is an x, which is of course equal to the point is, we're going to be able to provide a little bit of a change. So,
Thank you.